I'll be far behind. One of these mornings I'll leave these blues inside my mind. One of these mornings I'll sail away. Ain't no use pretending it's my lucky day. One of these mornings I'll lose these blues inside my mind. Well, I've been inside the blues so long, never saw the light. Your mind is filled with darkness, nothing ever turns out right. One of these moments set my troubles free, cast off all them demons that's been haunting me. One of these moments I'll lose these blues inside my mind. Entertainment Hall of Fame holiday party. We hope that you'll meet some of our board members here this evening and look at some of our new displays. I'd like to mention we got the brand new Marshall Trimble exhibit up over here. And I'd also like to mention we got our new case yesterday, or maybe it was today. We got our second case, and it only took 3 years to get that second case, so we're really moving fast. And that case is actually going to be reserved for the Reed family. It's been bought and sponsored for the Reed family, but we don't have all their stuff together yet, so we put some tube stuff in there, because we got a lot of tube stuff. But if you'd like to sponsor a case for the tubes, we sure would like you to do that, and you can find out about it back at our merch table, and we're looking for sponsors. And James, if I could get a little more guitar up here, I'd be a happier man. Ron, could you come up here for a second?
Yeah, by me.
So let's do a sing-along. Y'all ready? Okay, good. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, that was pretty good. Jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. Oh, what fun it is to sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Third album. Thank you very much. All right, this is my favorite Christmas song. What's coming on Christmas? They're cutting down trees. They're putting up reindeer, singing songs of joy. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. It don't snow here, stays pretty green. I'm gonna make a lot of money, I'm gonna quit this crazy scene. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. I wish I had a river so long. Now I teach my feet to fly. I wish I had a river could skate away. You know, I made my baby cry. You know, I'm so hard to handle. I'm selfish and I'm sad. And now I've lost the best baby that I've ever had. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. Now she tried hard to help me. Now she put me at ease. Now she loved me so naughty, made me weak in the knee. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. I wish I had a river so long. Now it teach my feet to fly. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. You know, I made my baby say goodbye. What's coming on Christmas? They're cutting down trees. They're putting up reindeer. They're singing songs of joy and peace. I wish I had a river I could skate away. I wish I had a river so long. Now I would teach my feet to fly. I wish I had a river I could skate away. Joni Mitchell song from the 60s. Thank you very much. All right, since we're in the Hall of Fame, I'd like to do a song by a guy that's in the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame. The late, great Buck Owens wrote this song. Movies. They're gonna make a big star out of me. about a man who's sad and lonely. All I gotta do is act naturally. And I bet you wanna be a big star. Might win an Oscar, you can never tell. Movie's gonna make me a big star. State historian, and he's an inductee in the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame. He has an exhibit right there. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Marshall Trimble.
Hi, everybody. I'm going to start again. This never happens to Johnny Cash. Are we a little loud there? Is that a little loud? Is that okay?
Up in the morning at the break of day, you'll hear a big rugged cowboy at the chuck wagon say, gather around boys, the coffee's hot on the bar. There's a full day of bread. We're heating the iron. I want to smell that scorched hair and burning hide. The horses are green, but they're ready to ride. Roll up your bedroll, jump in your boots. Daylight is a wasted, boys, we're out of the chutes. Come on and ride. Ride, cowboy ride. Ropers, get ready to bid your best. Saddle them ponies and tighten your cinch. Pull on your gloves and take your hats off the fence. We'll get the cattle to market, and after they're sold, you can haul it your hair down, get lazy or bold. Ride into town and find a lady or two. She'll grab you by your horns and shake the dust off your boots. Come on and ride, cowboy, ride. Roll up your riddles, pull your sombrero down tight. And come on and ride, ride, ride where the trail will wind. Better drive, 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 or we'll leave you behind. Come on and ride.
First started singing back in about 1963, when I was 3 years old. And I sort of always identified with it because I seemed to always have trouble with girlfriends' fathers. And I don't know why, but that's why I identified with this song.
Someday soon. And when I come to call, her paw ain't got a good word to say. And it's 'cause he's just as wild back in his younger days. So blow, you old blue northern, come blow her back my way. I'm driving in tonight from California, and I love that damned old rodeo just as much as I love her. Someday soon, go with me someday soon. Someday soon, going with me, someday soon, someday soon, going with me, someday soon.
I grew up in the little railroad town of Ashfork. It was a cattle shipping and railroad town, and just east of town was a steep canyon called Johnson Canyon. And when the Santa Fe Railroad was building west from Kansas City out to Los Angeles or the California coast in the 1880s, this was the worst hazard on the whole Santa Fe line, the most dangerous canyon. And they say that you can still see the wreckage of some of those trains that jumped the tracks going down Johnson Canyon. You can still see the wreckage today. So I took an old favorite folk song that I recorded on the Oblivion label many years ago, and it was a million seller. I got a million of them left, and they're still in the cellar. But anyhow, I'm following the old folk tradition. I took it and changed it from somewhere back east to Arizona. Oh, they gave him his orders in Winslow, Arizona, said Steve, you're way behind time. How this is not 38, this is old 97, better take her into Ashfork on time. He turned around and looked at his big greasy fireman, said, shovel on a little more coal. And when we cross old Johnson Canyon, you can watch old 97 roll. They headed westbound over Canyon Diablo, past Blackstaff and Williams too. Oh, he glanced at his watch, says, shovel more coal, this train ain't gonna be overdue. Well, there's a mighty steep canyon. There's a mighty steep canyon, Johnson Canyon, with a pine, with a 3 mile grade. It was on that hill that he lost his air brakes. You see what a jump he made. He was going down that road making 90 miles an hour when a whistle broke into a scream. Oh, they found him in the wreck with his hand on the throttle, scalded to death by the steam. Take a warning from this time on and learn. You never speak harsh words to your true lover husband. He may leave you and never return. Oh, he may leave you and never return. This is another song that I took and made an Arizona song out of it. Hope you like it. In a little cabaret in an Arizona border town sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came from all around and all the girls from there to Tucson. We're slipping away from home, putting their jewelry in, off to take a trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play. Thank you. didn't care to make a dime, just give him his guitar. He'd be happy all the time, and all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him, don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box. And he would play. Just in a few minutes here is Dolan Ellis, my old compadre for, oh, since about 1959. And Dolan and I both realized we're getting, you know, we're getting a little long in tooth, and we don't know what we're going to do with ourselves one of these days, but right now we just go out sometimes and have a drink. And the other night we were sitting in a bar, and Dolan says, hey, Marshall, see those two old guys over there, sitting over there? That's us in about 30 years. And I said, Dolan, you're looking in a mirror. Take a fine night.
If life was like a candlelight, then death must be the wind. You can close your window tight, but it still comes blowing in. So I will climb the highest hill and watch the rising sun. And pray that I won't feel the chill till I'm too old to die young. To see what they become. Oh Lord, don't let that cold wind blow, till I'm too old to die young. I once had a dear sweet friend I thought would never die, but the only thing that's left of them are the teardrops in my eyes. If I could have one wish today and know it would be done, I would say everyone could could stay till they're too old to die young. So let me watch my children grow to see what they become. Oh Lord, don't let that cold wind blow.
Tommy went to confession. He said, bless me, for I have sinned. Father Murphy said, who was it? Was it Megan or Marilyn? Was it Kathy, Brenda, or Fiona? Tommy just rattled his beads. The priest gave Tommy four Our Fathers and also five good leads. Now Shorty and Slim had to share a room one night in the big hotel. Shorty said, I snore so loud, I doubt if you'll sleep so well. Slim patted his butt, kissed him on the cheek, and said, oh, sweetheart, that's all right. Shorty went over and he sat in a chair and he stayed awake all night. Bad jokes, Lord, I love them. Bad jokes can't get enough of them. Hoo, 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 bad jokes for me. Now, oh, he went to the neighborhood dance and they won the big door prize. With a toilet brush and he took it home, and the next week one of the guys says, Oldie, how's that toilet brush, the one you won from the neighbors? Oldie said, you know, it works just fine, but I prefer toilet paper. I don't know if you knew it or not, but last summer, Lena signed up for the Sons of Norway Swimming Olympics, and she finished dead last in the breaststroke. And afterwards, she went up to the judge and she said, say, I don't like to complain, but I think those other girls were using their arms. Bad jokes, bad jokes. Don't get me started on these. Sven comes up to Ole and he says, hey, Ole, I think if you and Lena are going to be having sex in the middle of the afternoon in your living room, you should pull the curtains closed, because yesterday the whole neighborhood was out on the sidewalk watching. And Ole said, oh, Sven, you know, the joke's on them. I wasn't even home yesterday.
Bad jokes, Lord, I love them. Bad jokes can't get enough of them. Hoo, 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 bad jokes for me.
Now, Gramps turned 80 the other day, and everyone was there. He was all dressed up in a brand new suit and sitting in his rocking chair. A beautiful young naked girl jumped up before the group. She offered Gramps some super sex, and he said, I'll just take the soup.
Bad jokes.
One morning, the devil dropped into church in a cloud of smoke and flame. He ran up and down the aisle shouting, Lucifer is my name. I am evil, the eve, whore of all your dreams. The old man said, you don't scare me at all. I've been married to your sister too long, it seems. Oh, bad jokes, bad jokes. Now, this farmer had a champion bull bred 200 times a year. His wife said, 200 times? My, that's something, dear. Maybe you ought to watch him. Maybe he can show you how. Farmer said, you know, that's a heck of a bull, but it wasn't all with the same cow. When God created woman, instead of two breasts, he gave her three. But that middle one got in the way, so God performed surgery. this woman stood before God with her middle breast in her hand. She said, what shall I do with this useless food? And God created man. Bad jokes, all I can't get enough of them. Never criticize a person until you walk a mile in their shoes. That way, if they get mad, you'll be a mile away and they'll be barefooted. Okay, you're going to be in a good time. Dolan's all wound up and ready to go back here.
Marshall Trimble, ladies and gentlemen. He's the official state historian. All right, we're going to get Dolan up here, and Igor Glenn is going to sit in with him, Igor Glenn. And before we do that, I'd like to welcome you again to the this is our first holiday party, so hopefully we'll be doing this every year. We've had a lot of progress in the last few months, and you can see it in some of the stuff we've added to the hall. One of our best successes has been connecting with a lady named Mary Lynn Kelly. Mary Lynn, get ready and come on up here when you're ready. Come on up. She's with Restore Arts, and she's going to talk to you about a program that we're going to be working together with her on. And it's I'm getting a low thing in the monitors here. I'm talking about the monitors. I'm talking to the sound guy. Okay. So I'll just let Mary Lynn tell you about it. This is Mary Lynn Kelly from Restore Arts.
That was a great intro, huh? I want to be up front and tell everybody that there are a lot of roles that everybody has in music, and one of them needs to be the musician, but the only instrument I've been able to play is a radio or heart strings. So that's a stringed instrument. So anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about the path that led me toward the hall. There's a couple of things that I wanted you to know is, as we try to build and create a path for music, there are some things you have to pay attention to as you find that journey along Arizona. One of the things that I wanted to tell you is, I stumbled across Hans and when we were working together at the Tempe History Museum. And we knew that music needed to have a place. And I was captivated by the fact that they had the tagline for this organization is inspiring the future by remembering the past. So we started to brainstorm and think through what we could make happen. And I had taken a similar project. I don't know if anybody has had a chance to work on the west side, but there's this organization over there called the Challenger Space Center. And the Space Center was a program that I brought from a conversation to a Smithsonian affiliate for the Valley. So when Hans started saying, "This, we've got to make something really special happen," they have all the energy and they just needed to connect with what you do and how do you work a nonprofit. And a great idea was born. The idea that we had is to bring their mission to life, which is inspiring the future. So this organization has agreed to take part in an interactive laboratory, which brings this hall to life by having students that we've pre-screened that show a huge promise to becoming a later Hall of Famer that are here in Arizona. They'll get a chance to work one-on-one with these guys and girls that have been inducted into the hall and want to play it forward. So we're going to call this class the Backstage Class Playing It Forward. And we are doing this in collaboration with some fabulous partners. World Music Stage is here tonight, and they are the other dynamic portion that you have to have besides a huge skill in music. You also have to be an artist and an entrepreneur. The entrepreneur part is where World Music Stage stepped in and brought me through how you have to manage your music business. And I don't know, they're here somewhere, but between the, amongst the three of us, with the backstage class will be a full service program to provide the students the very best launch they can possibly have into the music industry. And I wanted to please thank all of you all, because being here tonight will launch that and support it financially. And there's a couple of ways you can do that if you'd like to do more specifically. Back in the back, there are some musical instruments. Whatever you want to donate towards that, we will put towards the launch of this class. And you can take one of the ornaments that we have there. But it has been a sheer pleasure to meet everybody. It has been such a joy. And I look forward to seeing where we are next year when we meet again. And I can bring you up to date on how many students have participated.
Mary Lynn Kelly. I'd also like to mention your Restore Arts donated an entire brand new drum set. And it's really nice, a nice drum set. We'll be using it as our back line. So a big hand for Mary Lynn and Restore Arts. Thank you very much. All right. Well, I'll let Dolan tell you all about Igor, but right now I'll introduce you to Arizona's official balladeer and inductee in the Arizona Music Hall of Fame, Mr. Dolan Ellis.
Thank you very much, thank you, and thanks for coming out this evening take part in this. I have an old friend with me here, we work together. I hate to use that name, but I have Santa Claus with me on stage here tonight. And this is Igor Glenn, and Igor and I worked together for a lot of years, traveled around all over the Western United States, and if Igor's guitar, or Igor's bass and my guitar could talk, we'd have to kill him. But that's been a long time ago. And let's do a little music here. Igor also was a member of the New Christy Minstrels, as I was one of the original members, and he came in a bit later. And what you need, buddy? You all right? Oh, good. All right. All right. Don't get too close. They'll talk. All right. Are you ready, buddy? Here we go, in the key of E, for those of you playing along out there. We're going to have to rehearse one of these days. Along Great Western Trail, take me back to track my heroes in those legends and those tales of the cowboys and the miners and the coming of the rails. Go on, Great Western Trail. Go on, Great Western Trail. Hear the rattling of a stagecoach, or the rumbling of its wheels, or the hoofbeat of a pony running U.S. mail. In the shadows of the hillside, you can almost touch for real, in a handshake with those heroes that we hail. From the border up on Canada, through the hills of Idaho, from the big skies of Montana to Wyoming, Buffalo, the canyon lands of Utah to Arizona's Navajo, through its Tulsa War Cactus, south of Mexico, south of Mexico, south of Mexico. Thank you. campfire. From my bedroll on the ground, with that western sky and ember all aglow, I wish this moment were forever, and I could stay right here somehow. And I wish I was born 100 years ago. It's getting pretty close, Igor. Rivers and the ridges where the eagle makes its nest. View the valleys from the vistas where the graveyards lay to rest. Those pioneering people who met the vision quest. They met the vision quest. They met the vision quest. Igor Glenn, ladies and gentlemen. I want to ask you a question. Have any of you ever seen that little cedar tree that grows between the northbound and southbound lanes of I-17 up by Sunset Point? Huh? Make a little noise if you've seen that tree. Well, that tree, you know, for those of you who may not have seen it, it's just a little juniper, a little cedar tree that grows up there. And for the last 30 years, somebody has been sneaking out there at Christmas time and decorating it with wonderful and beautiful ornaments. I'm sure many of you have seen it, because every season there are tens of thousands, maybe millions of people who see that tree. And yet, nobody really knows who is doing it. Well, I figured they've been doing that long enough that it has become a folk, an urban folklore of Arizona, and that needed to have a song written about it. And I just finished doing one, and I'd like to sing it for you this evening. And this is in the key of B for those of you playing along out there. And it goes like this. I figured this tree not only needed a song, it deserved to have a name. Nobody has ever given it a name till now, and I have named this little cedar tree, and its name is Scrubby. Scrubby. I mean, it's not a great, big, beautiful tree. It's kind of a scrubby sort of a tree, so that's why I gave it that kind of a name. So let me sing for you about our wonderful little scrubby tree on I-17. It's got all the beautiful ornaments on it, and who knows, maybe you'll be seeing it yet this holiday. It's decorated right now. Out in Arizona, there's a story to be told. A scrubby, the little cedar tree that grows beside the road. I-17 to Flagstaff from the desert down below. Random act of kindness to some secret caring soul. Each Christmas someone sneaks out there in the middle of the night. Decorates old Scrubby with Christmas balls so bright. It brings a smile to every face that passes by that sight. Yeah, Scrubby becomes a rock star, and for him this song I write. Scrubby is cedar tree, no one knew his name, till someone decorated him and gave him pride and fame. Now
magic of this mystery tree brings hope within our souls, that during these times of turmoil, a bell of goodness tolls, 'cause it tells the tale of Christmas that spreads across the land. And it's an inspiration to us all to love our fellow man. Scrubby is cedar tree, no one knew his name. For 30 years, we peel an eye as we pass by when Christmas time draws near. Like children play of Santa's sleigh and the sound of a reindeer. Each year we wait and anticipate for Scrubby to appear. Scrubby is cedar tree, no one knew his name. Decorated him and gave him pride and fame. Now, hopefully, the mystery of Scrubby will never be solved. Let's let it be the identity of whomever is involved, 'cause it shows the joy of giving in a pure and selfless way. Like the baby Jesus gave to us on that first Christmas day. Let's do this one. Here's a song that was written by a wonderful Arizona songwriter by the name of Dean Cook and Lon Austin. I think Tony Norris had something to do with this as well. It talks about coming down from Flagstaff at Christmas time. In the old days, it used to take 8 hours to get from Phoenix to Flagstaff. One way, 8 hours. Of course, today we have our brand new highway. It only takes, what, two and a half hours, something like that. This is an account of those old days in Arizona at Christmas time. Well, it was snowing up in Flagstaff, but we knew that the desert would be hot. So we crawled beneath the blankets, the dog always got the warmest spot. It was 2 days to Christmas when we climbed into the back of Dad's old truck. Breakfast down in Bear on old Highway 69. Cordis, then on down to Bumblebee. We're headed down for Christmas, and we brought the Christmas tree. And we'll stop at Old Rock Springs, where the water flows so clean. Cool water in the desert is a thirsty traveler's dream. And we'll stop at Old Rock Springs, where the water flows so clean. Traveler's dream. Today I'm headed down for Christmas. Black Canyon Freeway I will drive, with my kids just like I did when I was young and Grandma was alive. December winds are blowing, and the trees are covered white with snow. We'll be headed down for Christmas to the desert down below. And we'll stop at Old Rock Springs for that pie we love so dear. Oh, the memory that stop brings of our Christmas trip each year. When we stop at Old Rock Springs, where the water flows so clean. Cool water in the desert was a thirsty traveler's dream.
Thank you very much.
Well,
let's see what we're supposed to do here. Okay. Well, I think with Igor on bass here, we ought to do something where he could play that slap bass a little bit. It's, do you still ride your bass the way you used to, Igor? Yeah? Okay. All right. Okay. Well, here's an Arizona folk song. Now, maybe you may not realize that it's an Arizona folk song, but it certainly is. And it goes like this. Thank you.
had climbed to the top of his windmill down in southeastern Arizona. While he was up there, he turned around and he looked across those high plains of desert grassland. And he saw the clouds brooding over the mountain peaks in the distance in an awesome and mysterious sort of way. And this song, without a doubt, one of the most famous songs ever written in traditional Western music, was inspired by southeastern Arizona and written by Arizona cowboy Stan Jones. Their faces gaunt, their eyes was blurred, their shirts was soaked with sweat. They're riding hard to catch that herd, but they ain't caught it yet. Cause they got to ride forever on that range up in the sky, on horses snorting fire. And as they ride on, hear their get them sheep out of here, this is cattle country. He heard one call its name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on this train, then cowboy, change your ways today, or with us you will ride. Try and catch the devil's herd.
To hear sleigh bells.
think that this song, White Christmas, written by Irving Berlin, conjures up an image of snowfall and sleighs and horses and hot toddies and all sorts of wonderful winter scenes. And yet, you know what? Irving Berlin did not write this song in those kind of conditions. He wrote this song right here in Phoenix, Arizona. He was sitting around the pool at the Biltmore Hotel back in about 1939. And he was missing his home of Connecticut, and it was Christmas time. And so he was dreaming of a white Christmas. To you all.
Thank you.
Well, what are we going to do next? Oh, it's about that time. Where? Nah, it's been too long. I'll tell you what, we're supposed to be off by 20 after, and it's 20 after now, so maybe we ought to say goodbye. Okay. Happy New Year to all of you. Merry Christmas to all of you. And stick around. You got a lot of great entertainment coming up. Have fun. Igor Glenn. Igor, thank you, buddy. Thank you. Adios.
One more from Dolan Ellis.
Check. He's the boss. He be the boss. Okay. Here's one that I've been doing for a few years. In fact, I've done this for so many years that Igor and I used to do this in the late 1960s together. Tell the story of the sweethearts of Tuba City, Hank and Crystal. Well, run the truck stop, Tuba City, get the back bar, and get the place of looking for Dale Jones, to the folks, get the cars and the witty, get right down to the nubby nitty gritty. Who's gonna run the truck stop, Tuba City, when I'm gone, when I'm gone? Well now, Hank and Crystal, they moved out west to do the jobs they both knew the best. That was running the best truck stop you've ever seen. Hank worked back in the kitchen and cooked. Crystal waited tables with a sexy look. Before long, she became known as a truck stop. You know that title went to her head, and Hank became sorry he'd ever wed. That strong-willed woman began to boss him around. She'd yell and scream through the kitchen doors and tell Hank to get the lead from his drawers. I mean, she was always putting him down. Well, one day Hank had had it to his ears. He went to the cooler, had a couple of beers, took Crystal by the arm to the table, and he sat her down. Run the truck stop to the city, get the back bar clean, get the place looking pretty. Jokes to the folks, get the conversation with you, and they get right down to the nubby nitty gritty. Who's gonna run the truck stop to the city when I'm gone? Now when I'm gone. Now that Greyhound bus stopped every
every day to drop the mail while on its way to Reno, Silver City, Fresno, Tahoe, Bakersfield, and beautiful downtown Eloy. He said, "Woman, I done had enough of your cuss. I'm putting my bags on that Greyhound bus. You a plain bad fraud, and I had enough of your lip." Well, he stepped up to that sliding door. The bus took off with a roar, and as he hit the road, he bought a ticket for a one-way trip. Hank looked out the window of the back of the bus. There stood Crystal in the desert dust, standing on the bumper with her lips flapping in the breeze. She was pointing her finger and pounding on the glass, giving Hank a raspy sass. She wasn't about to let that poor man leave. And screaming that dizzy dame, people on the bus all began to turn and stare. Well, about that time, a sign said dip. Bristol did a twist and a triple flip, and hollered out the window as she flew through the air. Who's gonna run the truck stop? Jimmy said he'd get the back bar clean. Makes it looking pretty. Jokes to the folks, keep the conversation with it. Get by down to the nugget nitty gritty. Who's gonna run the truck stop? Jimmy said, "When I'm gone." Song. Hoping ladies won't take me wrong, but women's liberation needs a slightly different point of view. For a man has got to be a man. If you make him think he can, in turn, your man will make a woman out of you. Say, what you see is what you get. Yeah, you're the only one to know how we tick. I think that man and woman is here to stay. Think he's the boss, help him up and he gets lost. I guarantee you girls, you'll never hear him stick around and listen to that sass. You don't want to farm, honey. Thank you very much. Have a good time.
Let's have it one more time for Dolan Ellis and Igor Glenn.